tags. So web pages are composed of HTML tags, or more properly, elements. And most.
That's not exactly true. But we spent about 6 to 7 hours on C, and we spent about like 6 to 7 minutes on HTML.
Yeah, perhaps. But I don't think it really warrants a whole lot of time in class. I think we do spend time on what it is, this interpreted language. We explain to students that the browser reads it top to bottom, left to right, so to speak. We explain that it is the payload that's transmitted via HTTP. So all of the big picture items. And then we dive in a little deeper, pointing out the symmetry of most of the tags, open tags, closed tags, and so forth, how attributes can extend the definition of an element. But once you have that basic vocabulary, I'd liken it more to Scratch. Like once you understand how what the constructs are and what the puzzle pieces are that you have, you can go figure out how to assemble them. And you can Google and look online, look at online references to figure out what more functionality the language has. But for the most part, it's the concepts that matter, I think, in the class.
Right, and it's not all that intellectually compelling, like you said, as a programming language. It's not a programming language. It doesn't have control flow. It's really just
It's just markup. And we do introduce CSS, and we do use this as an opportunity to explain good design principles, albeit with very simple examples.
Abstracting away the CSS files.
Indeed, you can embed it first as a first pass, like with your style attributes, but that's a little messy, as we point out, and students start to realize. And you can put it at the top of your file, but then it's not really shared across multiple files, and therefore can't be cached. Mm-hmm. And so we use this, as we do many examples, as an opportunity to go from like version 0 to 1 to 2 and so forth to sort of get to a place that is the right way to do something, even though it's with fairly small examples early on.
But both HTML and CSS give us an opportunity to indeed encourage students to do that look up on their own. Even though I've been, you know, programming myself for a long time, I still look up HTML tags and what attributes I need to set to make things happen. I have to look up CSS selectors and
even the syntax. Yeah, it's fun, but it's not that intellectually interesting to store all of that in your head. And it's also changing too, so we want students to be going out and figuring out what the latest is, especially with HTML5. There's still a lot of older information where certain tags didn't exist, and so getting that exposure is good. And I think, too, we want to start to take training wheels off at this point in the semester so that as students near the end of the semester, they're not completely beholden to us for everything they're learning.
Right, they're feeling empowered to find things and build things that go far beyond the scope of the class that we even teach.
Exactly. We'll sort of help explain the world into which they're venturing, but it's up to them to like go find what they need at that point. Otherwise, they're too dependent on us by the time the term wraps.
Right.